Welcome to Adult Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. Pandora and the Box of Time. Chapter 1. The Discovery in Athens. In the heart of Athens, where ancient ruins whisper tales of a bygone era, a discovery at an archaeological site near the iconic Acropolis stirs the city into excitement. A mysterious box, unearthed from layers of history, captures the attention of the academic world and the public alike. The box, exquisitely crafted and adorned with intricate symbols, bears an inscription that references the mythical Pandora. Detective Elena Vasilis, known for her sharp intellect and deep knowledge of Greek mythology, is called to investigate the box's origins and significance. Elena, blending her detective skills with her passion for archaeology, arrives at the site with a mix of professional curiosity and cautious intrigue. The excavation site is a flurry of activity, with archaeologists and historians examining the find. The box, unlike any known artifact from ancient Greece, has no obvious opening or lock. Its surface is embellished with symbols that seem to depict various Greek gods, and at its center is an engraving of Pandora herself, known in myth for releasing the world's first evils from a similar box. Elena begins her investigation by consulting with the lead archaeologist, Dr. Nikos Petrakis. Dr. Petrakis explains that the box was found in a layer of soil that dates back to a period of great turmoil in ancient Greek history, suggesting that it could be over 2,000 years old. He shares his theory that the box might be connected to the ancient legends of Pandora, perhaps a symbolic representation crafted by an ancient artist. However, Elena senses there is more to the box than mere symbolism. The inscription on the box, when translated, speaks of captured time, a phrase that hints at something far more mystical and powerful. Intrigued by this clue, Elena delves into historical records and mythological texts, piecing together the legends surrounding Pandora and the gods of Olympus. Her investigation takes her to the National Archaeological Museum, where she pores over ancient manuscripts and artifacts. She discovers references to a mysterious object, described in several ancient texts, that was said to possess the power to manipulate time itself. These texts speak of a box crafted by Hephaestus, the god of blacksmiths and craftsmen, under the direction of Zeus. As Elena digs deeper into the mystery, she encounters Professor Ilias Constantinou, a renowned expert in Greek mythology. The professor shares his knowledge about the myth of Pandora, explaining that the original tale was not just about the release of evils into the world, but also about hope and the gods' intricate involvement in human affairs. Elena's inquiry leads her to a startling hypothesis. Could the box she is investigating be linked to these ancient myths in more than just symbolism? Could it indeed be a container for something as intangible and powerful as time itself? Her quest for answers becomes even more urgent when she learns of a recent string of unexplained events in Athens, instances where time appeared to behave anomalously, almost as if influenced by an external force. These events, though dismissed by many as mere coincidences or technical glitches, align disturbingly with the box's discovery. As Elena contemplates the implications, she receives an anonymous tip about a group of modern-day cultists who worship the ancient Greek gods. These cultists, the tip suggests, are deeply interested in the box and believe it to be a key to unleashing divine powers. Realizing the potential dangers of the box falling into the wrong hands, Elena decides to trace the cultists. Her investigation takes her through the winding streets of Athens, from the shadowed alleys of Plaka to the busy squares of Syntagma, where ancient history and modern life collide. As night falls over Athens, Elena stands before the Parthenon, the eternal symbol of the city's ancient glory. She reflects on the weight of her discovery, a relic that could be a link to the mythical past, holding secrets that blur the line between legend and reality. Chapter 2: The Curse of Chronos. As Elena Vasilis delved deeper into the mystery of the box and its connection to the ancient Greek gods, she found herself navigating a labyrinth of myths and historical records. Her next lead took her to the reclusive Professor Ilias Constantinou, an expert in Greek mythology who had dedicated his life to studying the lesser-known myths of the gods, particularly Chronos, the personification of time. In his cluttered study, surrounded by walls of ancient texts and artifacts, Professor Constantinou revealed to Elena a fascinating and obscure tale about Chronos. According to legend, Chronos, fearing a prophecy of being overthrown by his offspring, sought to create a contingency, a fragment of time, captured and hidden away. This fragment, imbued with the essence of Chronos himself, possessed the ability to manipulate and distort time. The professor theorized that the box might be connected to this myth. He suggested that it could be the vessel crafted by Hephaestus, designed to contain the fragment of time. The craftsmanship and symbols on the box supported this theory, indicating a divine origin and purpose. Elena, intrigued by this possibility, realized the grave implications if such power were to be unleashed. She knew that the box could not fall into the wrong hands. Her fears were compounded when she learned of a modern-day cult that worshipped the ancient Greek gods and sought to harness their powers. This cult, known for its secretive and ritualistic practices, believed that releasing Chronos' fragment could grant them control over time itself. Determined to prevent such a catastrophe, Elena embarked on a quest to trace the cult and understand their intentions. Her investigation led her to the dark underbelly of Athens, where whispers of the cult's activities surfaced in hushed conversations. Elena's first encounter with the cult came sooner than expected. One evening, while following a lead, she found herself ambushed by cloaked figures in an abandoned warehouse. Using her quick thinking and combat training, she managed to escape, but the encounter left her with no doubts about the cult's dangerous intentions. As the investigation progressed, Elena uncovered evidence of the cult's widespread influence, extending even into the ranks of influential figures in Athens. She realized that this was more than a mere archaeological investigation. It was a race against time to prevent a potential disaster. Elena's search for the cult's leader, rumored to be a charismatic and persuasive figure with deep knowledge of ancient rituals, took her across Athens. She visited ancient ruins, deciphered coded messages left in historical sites, and navigated through a maze of cryptic symbols and clues. The breakthrough came when Elena discovered an ancient manuscript in the National Library of Greece. The manuscript contained detailed descriptions of a ritual to invoke the power of Kronos, including references to a vessel that matched the description of the box. It also hinted at the location of the cult's next gathering, a secluded site near the ruins of Delphi, the ancient sanctuary of Apollo. Armed with this knowledge, Elena prepared to confront the cult. She knew that the ritual, if completed during the upcoming lunar eclipse, could unleash the fragment of time and cause untold chaos. The detective made her way to Delphi, determined to stop the cult and secure the box. As Elena journeyed to Delphi, the weight of her responsibility weighed heavily on her. She was not only a detective seeking to solve a case, but also a guardian standing against forces that threatened to disrupt the very fabric of time. Chapter 3. Shadows of Olympus. Elena Vasilis' journey to unravel the mystery of the box and thwart the cult's intentions led her to the ancient ruins of Delphi, a site steeped in myth and history. As she navigated the rugged terrain, the shadows of Mount Parnassus seemed to whisper secrets of the past, reminding her of the thin line between myth and reality. Upon arriving in Delphi, Elena felt the weight of history surrounding her. The ruins of the once great oracle, where kings and warriors sought guidance, now lay in silent testament to the power of prophecy and divine will. It was here, amidst these echoes of the past, that Elena prepared to confront the cult and prevent their ritual to invoke Kronos' power. The detective's investigations have revealed that the cult planned to perform the ritual during the lunar eclipse, believing that the celestial event would amplify the fragment of time's power. Elena knew that she had little time to act. She scoured the ruins, searching for signs of the cult's presence, her every step shadowed by the looming threat of what might be unleashed. As night fell and the moon began its celestial dance, casting Delphi in an eerie light, Elena finally located the cult's gathering site. Hidden in a secluded valley near the Castalian Spring, the cultists, robed in chanting, were already assembling. Their leader, a charismatic figure with an air of ancient knowledge, stood at the center, preparing to conduct the ritual. Elena, realizing the urgency of the situation, decided to act. Disguised in a cloak, she infiltrated the gathering, blending in with the cultists. As she moved through the crowd, she overheard fragments of conversation that revealed the depths of the cult's belief in their cause. They spoke of a new era, where time would be theirs to control, reshaping history to their design. The ritual began with the cult leader invoking the ancient gods and calling upon the power of Kronos. Elena, seizing her opportunity, disrupted the ritual by covertly removing the key element, a relic essential to the ritual's completion. Her actions caused confusion among the cultists, buying her precious time, and the ensuing chaos, Elena confronted the cult leader, challenging his motives and revealing her identity as a detective. The cult leader, undeterred, engaged her in a battle of wits. He spoke of his vision for a world free from the constraints of time, where the mistakes of the past could be undone and the future could be rewritten. Elena, countering his arguments, emphasized the dangers of tampering with the fundamental laws of nature. She argued that time, much like fate, was not something to be controlled but respected. The debate reached its climax as the lunar eclipse reached totality, casting a shadow that seemed to engulf the entire valley. Amidst this shadow confrontation, Elena's words began to sway some of the cultists, who started to doubt their leader's intentions. Realizing that his plan was unraveling, the cult leader attempted a desperate final act to complete the ritual himself. In a dramatic showdown, Elena managed to thwart his attempt, using her knowledge of ancient Greek rituals to counteract his actions. The relic, essential to the ritual, was secured, and the fragment of time remained contained within the box. As the eclipse passed and the moon's light returned, the cultists dispersed, their belief shaken by the night's events. The cult leader, defeated and disillusioned, was taken into custody by the authorities, whom Elena had alerted before confronting the gathering. Chapter 4. Sealing the Box of Time. In the aftermath of the dramatic confrontation at Delphi, Elena Vasilis stood among the ancient ruins, the box containing the fragment of time safely in her possession. The lunar eclipse had passed, leaving behind a tranquil night that belied the intensity of the events that had just unfolded. With the cult's plan thwarted and their leader in custody, Elena knew that the immediate danger was over, but the question of what to do with the box remained. She understood that such a powerful artifact required careful handling and protection from those who might seek to misuse its powers. Elena's journey back to Athens was contemplative. She pondered the cult leader's words and the allure of the power to control time. Despite his misguided intentions, his desire to rewrite history resonated with her, reminding her of humanity's enduring fascination with time and fate. Upon her return, Elena consulted with Professor Constantinou and Dr. Petrakis, sharing her experiences and seeking their advice on securing the box. They agreed that the artifact was too dangerous to be left in the open and needed to be placed under strict protection. The decision was made to secure the box in a specially designed vault within the National Archaeological Museum, where it could be studied and safeguarded. Elena, Professor Constantinou, and Dr. Petrakis worked together to create a secure environment for the box, employing both modern technology and ancient protective symbols to ensure its containment. As preparations for the box's transfer to the museum were underway, Elena received an unexpected visit from an envoy of the Greek Ministry of Culture. The envoy expressed the government's gratitude for her efforts and offered her a position as a special consultant on matters involving ancient artifacts and their modern implications. Elena was honored by the offer and saw it as an opportunity to continue her work in protecting Greece's cultural heritage. The day of the box's transfer to the museum arrived. A small ceremony was held, attended by key figures from the archaeological community, government officials, and the media. Elena was commended for her bravery and dedication, and the box was placed in its new home, where it would be studied and preserved. However, Elena knew that the story of the box was far from over. She understood that as long as the box existed, it would continue to attract interest and perhaps even danger. She pledged to remain vigilant, ready to protect the artifact from those who might seek to unlock its secrets. In the final scene, Elena stood in the museum, gazing at the securely sealed box. She reflected on her journey and the lessons she had learned about time, history, and the human desire to wield power over the unknown. She realized that the box, like Pandora's box of ancient myth, contained more than just tangible dangers. It held questions about humanity's place in the grand tapestry of time.